Yeah, so since you have, you have mentioned about the government arsenal, see every budget hearing, yan ang paborito kong binabantayan palagi, yung improvement o whatever issues about government arsenal, yan, napaka-crucial po niyan, yung defense and security. Kaya, yung sabi mong talagang up with the demands or the requirements of the armed forces alone, yung ating arsenal, which is supposed to be, talagang dapat dyan tayo maasa. Kasi local, atin talaga yan, atin talaga yan. Pagdating ang araw na kinakailangan natin yung bala, pag nagkagira sa buong mundo, wala tayong magpupunan ng bala sa ibang bansa, kundi sa atin kung meron tayong sariling pagawaan. So yan, palagang tinututukan ko. But apparently, Mr. Chair, over the years, napansin ko, parang DND itself or is not keen on improving the government arsenal. Dahil, alam niyo, sa buong Pilipinas, nakikita ko, Mr. Chair, sa buong Pilipinas, yun palang yung nagkakahirapan tayo magbili ng primer dahil nagsimula yung Ukraine War, gano'n gano'n, hirapan tayo magbili ng primer. Nalaman ko, sa buong Pilipinas, yung government arsenal lang pala natin ay ang mayroong machine na gumagawa ng primer. Sabi ni, tapos at sino magkawa ngayon? Sinong director ng government arsenal?
Jerry Amate.
Ah, siya pa rin. Abin ko kung siya pa rin kasi doon lang kami nag-start ng discussion ng Mr. Chair. Tayo mo lang pala sa buong Pilipinas mayroong pagawaan ng primer. And it's very crucial, Mr. Chair. Even yung pinakamalaking kumpanya ng firearms industry dito sa Pilipinas, yung Arms Corps, wala silang pagawaan ng primer. Talaga nag-i-import pa silang primer. At tayo sa arsenal, mayroong pala. So sana masuportahan natin ito. At alam mo, yung Arms Corps nga, sabi niya sa nag-usap kami, pangarap nila makabili ng ganun kasing machine at it required billions of pesos para sila makaproduce niyan. Tayo, meron na pala tayo. And bakit hindi natin kaya masuklayan yung ating parang in the interest of convenience, sinasabi ng ating DND o ng armed forces na magkonte, bili lang tayo dyan sa labas o anong meron. Instead of developing our own, out of convenience nga, diretso na. So, tapos, tutukan mo lang natin yan yung ating government arsenal. Yun lang. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Senator Bato, for giving us very important information.
Yes, asking. Mr. Chair, the Secretary recognizes the need to strengthen and modernize the government arsenal. In fact, Mr. Chair, he already instructed the Office of the Undersecretary for Acquisitions and Resource Management to study the matter of entering into partnerships and arrangements with other defense contractors, Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chair, alam mo, panahon ni President Marcos noon, mga kadinti pa kami, nagtutur kami dito sa Metro Manila. Hindi ko lang maalala kung ano mga lugar yun, pero mayroong pagawaan ng yung mga bala ng mortar set, di ba? May pagawaan ng mga bala ng Indo-Utre, yung research and development, RDC, component. Ewan ko, meron mo bang RDC ang dindingasyon? Yun ang problema, nawala na yun. Kaya ang masabi natin, after Marcos, totally nag-decline talaga yung capability ng forces at ng military natin, yung defense natin, yun, nawala yung mga RDC. Meron tayong pagawa ng missile noon eh. Mayroon tayong paggawa ng mga mini-cruiser sa sariling sasakyan ng military. Sayang, Mr. Chair, sana, yun nga, with this issue na self-reliance defense posture, dapat dandahan natin babalik towards that level during the Marcos era. Yun lang, Mr. Chair, thank you.
Ang laging problema kasi dito, maraming factors that deter the improvement of the government arsenal. One, una-una yung procurement act natin. Yun ang problema. That's why I think dito sa National Defense Act, amendment na lang natin because yung ating AFP or for any government agency for that matter cannot purchase, cannot acquire second hand. Eh, hindi naman tayo yung TNT or AFP, TNT, hindi naman tayo bumili ng brand new. For example, aeroplano, helicopter, or mga pa rin, sa sobrang mahal, hindi tayo maka-afford na makapili ng bago. So, sabi nga ni Senate President Suveri kanina, meron nga sa US, meron yata kung silang dinidispose ng mga firefighter jets yata, na second hand, na mura. And hindi naman sila pwede mag-afford na second hand nga. So that's why we have to do something about it. We have to amend the procurement act in order for us to avail of the sale from the United States, na yung mga murang equipments nila. Anyway, I understand it is only the NDCP who has submitted their position paper with regard to this SRDP bill or the National Defense Industry Act. Pwedeng submitted na.
We undertake to submit.
So 2 weeks, pwede 2 weeks.
Yes,
sabay-sabay na yung National Defense Act. Any other resource persons who wishes to
Mr. Chair,
give their inputs? Attorney Fanolan?
Yes, from the Commissioner of Higher Education. Regarding this bill, it's just, we're just interested if there is a possibility of including a defense and security research agenda in the higher education sector, which would of course require appropriate funding. As you may observe in other jurisdictions, the collaboration between higher education institutions and the defense establishment is actually quite rich and has produced a lot of technological developments and even policy studies, which are quite critical when it comes to both our soft and hard approach to our defense posturings. It could be one of those areas of additional incentives, funding, and even research creation, where we would be able to manage also the kinds of research that we produce so that it doesn't also fall into the wrong hands, and also allowing access to our higher education institutions, our scholars, as researchers, inventors, innovators, and even those in the higher education research field to have a better collaborative environment with the defense establishment. That's all, Mr. Chair.
Thank you very much, sir. Okay, thank you. We learned that the defense and military industrial economic zone will rise in Bataan, am I correct? Meron a defense and military industrial economic zone na itatayo sa Limay, Bataan. Following the signing of MOA between the authority of Freeport area of Bataan and the government arsenal of the proposed declaration of the defense industrial estate in the province, is this true? Am I correct? Or is this a misinformation?
We'll verify the information.
You're not aware of this?
We're not.
Meron ng MOA signing between the government arsenal and the Freeport area of Bataan. The Senate President has already mentioned this. You're not aware of it?
No, we're checking out your honor.
Anyway, these two bills that we have been discussing since this morning are very important bills that has to be discussed and deliberated further. And as soon as we receive all the position papers of all stakeholders concerned regarding these two very important bills, and I plan to pass these two bills before the year ends. Okay, and I hope to get all your support and cooperation with these two very interesting and very important bills that we have discussed. Okay, any any other resource persons who wishes to speak with regard to the matter? Yes, you say.
Yes, I just want to reiterate what you emphasized, because these two bills are in the are supportive of the Philippine Development Plan, particularly two major chapters of the Philippine Development Plan, the chapter 13.1, ensuring peace and security, and chapter 8.2, advancing research and development, technology and innovation. And these two bills are also in the legislative agenda of the Philippine Development Plan, and also our commitments in the LILA. So, again, we would like to, so we are supporting these bills. We have provided our detailed inputs for the National Defense Bills last May, calendar 2023, and again we will be providing our inputs for the SDRT between the bills shortly, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Yusen Cabalsatos. What department are you representing?
I'm in
the
National Economic and Development.
I'm in that. Yes. All right. Thank you very much. What about the DDI? Meron na mga position paper. You have to submit your position paper with regard to the two bills that we are discussing right now.
Hi, sir. Good morning, all. DDI is currently reviewing and finalizing the position in terms of these two bills.
But you're still reviewing it? You haven't come up with a...
There are multiple offices for that giving comments for regarding this one. And our office, the certificate management office, just one of the offices.
When did you submit your position paper?
Sir, we will consult them for the IPR.
2 weeks for that? 2 weeks? Kaya
na? Yes, sir.
Okay.
Mr. Chair, for the BOI,
BOI,
for the investment.
Okay.
It's going to be the same. We're going to submit. Position paper. But it's the DTI that consolidates all these positions.
Yes, please.
Thank you very much.
All right. Yes, sir.
Regarding the Defense Industrial Economic Zoning Divide, there is no MOU yet.
There is no?
Yeah.
Merong press release ang Philippine News Agency. Defense and military industrial economic zone will soon rise in this province to encourage investors in defense projects to establish their manufacturing plants in the country. The authority of the Freeport Area of Bataan, or the AFAB, and the government arsenal signed on Monday a memorandum of agreement to the proposed declaration of defense industrial estate here as the newest expansion area of the Freeport Area of Bataan. I think the Senate President mentioned this earlier when he was here. But ninyo alam. This was, June 28 last year. 2022 pa.
Mr. Chair, we were not aware. It's 2022, Mr. Chair, June 27, 2022. We were not there yet. We're not aware. But among the things, Mr. Chair, is we are currently considering, it's already included, Mr. Chair, in the SRDP roadmap, the defense industrial complex in Limay Bataan.
So, no one of you are aware of the signing of the MOA between Bataan and the government arsenal?
Mr. Chair, I'm not personally aware, Mr. Chair, but it's included in the defense industrial complex in Limay Bataan. It's included in the...
Please check your facts, naman.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Okay, before that, I would like to acknowledge the presence of Senator Amy Marcos.
Senator Amy. Apologies to the chairman and to the rest of you as presiding over a meeting in the other room. I hope you're still talking about the SRDP. Am I still on time?
We are currently discussing about it, Senator Marcos.
Yes. I am in receipt of the other versions of the bills and having consulted with so many of our commanders in all the different areas from Norcom to Westcom to Southcom, Westcom, Eastcom, and the rest, I would simply like to add a few things that they requested. That they requested on the ground, and these are the guys who are fighting for us. Una-una, sabi ko, kung maaari, imbes na ang use reklamo ng defense technology sa DND, kung maaari magkaroon ng SRDP Council. Sa panahon ngayon, na ilokano ng ating Pangulo at namamayapag ang mga nagtitipid, eh talagang ayaw natin na magtatag ng bagong konseho. Ganun pa man, mukhang mahalaga na magkaroon ito dahil if the council shall be the policy-making body to oversee the implementation of an SRDP program, it will be chaired necessarily by the SND, but must be composed of the DFA, the DOF, the DOST, DBMNED, the DOH, and the ICT, given the myriad tasks already assigned to the AFP, particularly in times of calamities and disasters. Also, in view of the new external threats that have pushed us out of a solely internal viewpoint. There's a secretariat, there's an executive committee, there's a formal program, and that should include defense as well as disaster response, since we're all reliant upon the AFP to do this work. Further, aside from this, we have indicated that you'll be better and easier to monitor as well the private entities. I refer to the defense manufacturers in the SRDP program. It will be easier to monitor the financial incentives for R&D and so on. They will be getting tax incentives. They will not be under the FIRB. So they need to be monitored by someone else. So there was a sense that the USEC would have too much on his plate and would require some help from the DOF, DOI, and PESA, and so on. Also, I wanted to state that at least 50% of the defense-related material under the SRD should be those required under the AFP Modernization Program. We are well aware that we are far behind on Horizon 2 and 3, and there's some work left over from Horizon 1 even. So critical components should be procured under the AFP program. Unahin na natin yung modernization na nagiging himala na lamang. Dinagdag ko rin na yung modernization ng mga government arsenal and Philippine Aerospace Development Corporation, both places, to which I've been, and nakakaawa ko yung itsura nyo na napakagagalit ng ating mga engineers sa Army. Kaya lang, talaga na lang, buko-buko na lang ang kanilang trabaho. Hirap-hirap na talaga sila at ang luluma ng kasangkapan. And this would likewise require the SRDP program to provide material, equipment, and vehicles necessary to effectively respond to disasters and public health emergencies, such as the COVID-19, which will not be the last. And finally, and this I have heard repeatedly by everyone in almost every single command, the deletion of the requirement in Section 4B of RA-7898 that major equipment and weapon systems shall be purchased by the AFP must be used by the armed forces of the country of origin or the armed forces of at least two countries. Alam na natin na ang nangyari sa ating mga baril, marami namang napoproduce dito sa Pilipinas. Pero dahil sa requirement na ito, namimili tayo sa Korea imbes na bumili ng baril dito na gawang Pilipino. They are pre-disqualified, and it's entirely wrong to pre-disqualify our local manufacturers, to my mind. Thank you. Lastly, and I believe this is an area where we used to be much more active, and that is a special lane in the Intellectual Property Office to handle the applications of patents and other industrial designs of the AFP. You can also derive some income when these patents, for example, are demilitarized and open for commercial production.
And in the time of export, the AFP and FNB could actually create a new revenue stream with these patents and industrial design copyrights. Eh, hindi pa ginagawa ngayon. Eh, dati-dati, ang daras-daras ninyo mag-copyright sa military establishment. Ngayon na wala na, at higit sa lahat, wala pang kinikita. So, maybe that's an area that we need to exploit. Yun lang po, Mr. Chair.
Thank you very much, Blooming Senator, Senator Marcos. Oh, may I know your comments on the opening statement of Senator Arby?
Why?
Okay. Yes, sir. What about the AFP? Di ba natin narinig yung Armed Forces of the Philippines? Simula kanina.
Yes, sir. To the... To the chairman, sir. This morning, I'm the attendees of this hearing. Sir, with regards to the part of the AFP, we really appreciate and we are very privileged to have that position of the beloved senators regarding the SRTP program. We have here the Senate Bill number 315 by Senator Sumiri, the Senate Bill number 505 by Senator Revilla, Senate Bill 2046 by Senator Marcos Mam, and of course the Senate Bill 682 by Senator Stanser. Sir, with regards to that, It is a great help for us if we are going to really push through with the SRDP program. Citing the circumstances on our part in the AAP, sir, with regards to the AAP modernization, we believe that it is a very tedious process when we are reaching 635 days in the implementation of our AAP modernization project. And with regards to the statements earlier, that there will be basically a probability of opposing the exemption of the AAP with the procurement process, particularly the AAP modernization, I believe it would be a great help for us to really, procure and eventually support our modernization program. And aside from that, sir, in the implementation of the SRDP program, we would just like to have this proposal that there will also be a continuity of these our MICA projects in terms of AAP modernization. Pending the SRDP program, maybe we will still continue procuring from our foreign counterparts. Of course, also, I think we really have to take the SRDP program as part of a security strategy, and that's just a program per se, but since we'll also be affecting our economy. That's why we have here the other departments. It should be a national government approach. Sir, I think, to the Mr. Chair, since we have here the NEDA, the DTI, and the other agencies, that will be very great help also in the pursuit of this SRDP, the participation of the other departments. And it's also for our local industries also, preferential attention also for the local industries for the procurement of our essential equipments. And of course, lastly, I would just like to reiterate those the thing, particularly the simplification of our procurement process. And I think, sir, on the part of the AP, that would be all.
Yes, thank you very much. I'd like to react, yes. Mr. Chairman. And again, I heard two things. One was the delusion as stated of the requirement of two states or two governments or two armed forces using the same. We're fully aware that the Philippines long ago was actually producing through Presidential Decree 415 armaments such as the M16 assault rifles, pistols, the 45s were being produced here in the Philippines, 81 millimeter mortar tubes, gun barrels, ammunition like 5.56 millimeter ammunition, hand grenades, MK2, the 81 mortar ammunition. We were able to produce vehicles like the Jiffy Jeeps. I think everyone remembers the Mini Cruiser. We all learned to drive on those little things. We had also for the Navy hovercraft, speedboats, Marcelo boats, PCF, LCBP, whale boats. Lahat yan nawala na. at para tayong binabaril natin ang sarili natin dahil na-require natin na ginamit na ng dalawang nakaraang sandatahang lakas. Ikalawa, ayaw pa natin iligtas sila sa procurement law. Eh, natatawag na yung mga Israeli sa atin, sabi, dapat top secret yan. Bakit lahat ng acquisition nasa lahat ng dyaryo sa buong Pilipinas? Anong kalokohan na security yan? So, paulit-ulit po yun na kung maaari may limited supervision lamang sa procurement at visitorial powers, pero wag naman pilitin yung mga publication and other requirements sa procurement law. So, isa yun at yung isa na, na wag naman pinapatay yung ating mga local manufacturers. Maraming salamat po.
Thank you, Senator Amy. I would like to acknowledge the presence of Senator Rafi Kulpo. Senator Rafi, you may want to give a statement before we
Mr. Chair, meron naman kasi ako isang concern at katanungan yung sa section 10 ng proposed law tinatanggal ata dito ang stated yung sa procurement na yung single largest completed contract. Is that
The reason behind this, if
yung pong safeguard meron pa.
Kasi kanina nandito si Senate President Meeks. Ang problema kasi niyan, if we don't exempt itong AFP from this procurement act, hindi sila makabili. We cannot afford, or they cannot afford to buy brand new equipments. For example, like ang sinabi ni Senate President F-16. Hindi naman nila kaya yung bumili. Eh, meron niya nag-offer ang United States government na dispose na nila yung kanilang F-16 in a much cheaper price. Although, slightly used o second hand na tinatawag, hindi naman sila makabili ng second hand because bawal sa atin na mag-purchase o mag-acquire ng second hand equipments. So, yun ang naging basihan. You cannot purchase. Or not only the AFP, not only BBNT, all government agencies concerned, like NGOs, they cannot buy second-hand equipments or other products. And yun ang one of the basis for exempting the DFD or the AFP from this procurement.
Pero ano naman po yung safeguard? Meron tayo para hindi yung makapasok, mga fly-by night.
Maybe we can discuss this in a in the PWG to have the safety net implemented.
Thank you, Your Honor. Hindi na muna. Thank you, hindi na muna.
Actually, patapos na tayo sa okay. If you have your questions, we can give you this
yes,
etc.
Wala na po akong question kasi late ako dumating, so okay. Hindi ko narinig yung proceedings. Galing po ako dun sa barangay mga health workers, which is about sa proponent ng big. Anyway, magandang umaga po sa inyo lahat, ladies and gentlemen. Napaganda sa alit kong sabihin ito kung nakakabot mo sa alam kong magala. At anyway, gusto ko na parating na suportahan ako po ang ating PFP. Lahat ng ating katundaluhan dahil po sa inyo po, sa inyo na nagbibigay proteksyon sa bayan. And I can assure you with my own support, all our support sa ating mga magala. Maraming salamat, Mr. Chair.
Thank you for your kind words, Senator Rafi. At this juncture, this committee will create a TWG or Technical Working Group on the two bills to further discuss the fine details of the measure. And I expect and I hope that the stakeholders concerned will be able to submit their respective position papers on these two bills that we have discussed this morning.
Mr. Chairman, ako tanong, ano na off topic to? Yung pinaka-recent nakita ko sa group chat natin na itong Chinese Coast Guard na naman, nisprehan ng tubig, yung mga tubig, yung ating Coast Guard.
Coast Guard.
Ano pong reaksyon ng ating military ito dito ng ating National Department of National Defense? Parang pawit-ulit na lang po ito at sobra ng pangapi at pangapuso tinagawa sa atin ng China. In reaction from the AFP and from the DMD?
Maybe the AFP is just beside you.
Yeah. Kasi nakita po yung video, eh, na-hybrid po ako. Grabe po yun. Eh, nag-deliver lang po ng supply. Nire-supply lang po natin Philippine Coast Guard. Yung pong mga sundalo natin na naka-base sa lugar doon sa pinagkukunti sa territory. Eh, pinuha po ng tubig itong Coast Guard ng China. Meron mga bang Chinese Coast Guard? Binomba po yung ating Philippine Coast Guard. May reaction na ba yung DND tungkol doon? Nakapag-issue ba, Mr. Chair? Yung hindi yung share this year? I have a question.
Masikli?
Mr. Chair, the AFP last Saturday issued a statement of condemnation, Mr. Chair, condemning the excessive and unlawful actions against the Philippine Coast Guard. The DND shares the same.
Nandiyan condemnation na tayo, Senator.
Oo nga, parating na kaya ang kasigurahan.
Hanggang mga mag-file tayo diplomatic protest that it's always falling in deaf ears.
Eh, pag isa-dios na lang natin siguro, magdasal na, mag-pray na lang tayo. Maraming Panginoon at hindi naman ulit siya. Anyway, aside from condemnation from DND, wala ko yung ginagawa pag-iusap sa inyong counterparts sa China para sabihin sa akin, hey, this is too much. Diba? Or siguro next time, I don't know, ayaw ko na magkakaroon ng confrontation between China and the Philippines. Philippine military and the Chinese military, alam ko naman, parang ilipanti at langgam lang tayo, ilipanti sila. Pero is it possible na kapag nag-resupply yung ating Philippine Coast Guard ng pagkais, mga katropa natin, eh, escorted po ng ating Philippine Navy, would that help? Para maging kahit o paano, mapigilan itong Philippine Coast Guard natin yung ayaw yung itong Chinese Coast Guard at pihin natin Philippine Coast Guard. Kung meron ang escort na taga-Philippine Navy.
Hello, Mr. Chair. Actually, every time we make the order of the resupply to our troops in the UV, the boats, the civilian boats we use, are escorted by the Coast Guard and then the Philippine Navy. Every time we do that.
So yung nangyari po yun, meron po, escort po yung Philippine Coast Guard.
Yes.
Ah, escort na po, tapos kaya
escort.
Oo.
Yes. And aside from that, aside from this non-coordination, actually the counterpart, our DAFA, our DAFA in China, is also sending aggressive messages against the people in China. Of the illegal actions of the Chinese Coast Guard. So they could put it there. There was a very strong statement against the illegal act of the Chinese Coast Guard. And aside from that, the diplomatic protests is always being carried out by the Coast Guard. The FAA, fully supported by the Department of Defense.
I'm sure they're winning pag-usap na sa inyong counterparts sa Chinese government. Ano yung usually po ang binibigyan nilang reason kung bakit nila nagawa yun, nagawa na nila mga kapuhan yun?
Actually po, sir, it is the Department of Foreign Affairs doing the
dialogue
with the Chinese.
Do you have any representative from the Department of Foreign Affairs?
Yes.
You may answer the question of Senator.
Good morning, Mr. Chair. Good morning, Senators. Gusto ko lang pong ipalam na yung Department of Foreign Affairs po kasama ng national task force in the West Philippine Sea. Meron tayong inter-agency task force. Meron pong importante press briefing na itaganap today, this afternoon, at yung ating National Security Advisor ko na siyang chair ay magbibigay ko ng statement to clarify ano po yung nangyari at kung ano po yung ating ginagawa ngayon. So, I would not like to preempt what the National Security Advisor will be saying this afternoon, but we would just like to reassure for the body that the DFA and the other members of the National Task Force are fully aware of the reports and the circumstances that have happened, and we share the concerns of our armed forces of the Philippines and the PCG, who were directly affected by the incident, and also the more importantly, the service personnel affected. Yung DFA, well, we are undertaking all diplomatic measures with regards to this incident, and we will provide it's ongoing ngayon, Senator, both in our embassy in Beijing and here in the DFA. We are coordinating with our relevant counterparts, and we will provide updates of this afternoon on what has been done so far.
Ang tinatanong kasi si D. Senator Rafi, because of the repeated Chinese incursions within our territory, nakapag-dialogo na ba kayo sa inyong Chinese counterparts before? So, at kung ano ba ang sinasabi ng inyong Chinese counterparts during your dialogues? Kasi madalas na itong nagkakaroon ng Chinese incursions.
The Philippines, we reiterate our position na the features that are in the West Philippine Sea are one, that they are part of our they fall under, we have sovereignty, sovereign rights, and jurisdiction over these features.
Hindi siya ba sinasabi sa China, oy, lumayos na kayo dyan, sabot na kayo makilang
dito. Sir, we convey what the position na these are sa ating poton. And of course, the Chinese will convey their position. They will convey that they also have their rights and jurisdiction. So we at every opportunity, we reassert and re-emphasize for our sovereignty, sovereign rights, and jurisdiction.
Senator.
Okay na po, Mr. Chair, thank you. Meron na po sa akin no, sa mga staff ko, mga nalala ko, meron po katanungan dito ngayon. Kasi noong 2022, the Philippine government canceled the 12 billion peso contract, yung purchase ng 16 Russian-made helicopters na nga po sa issues sa Russia and Ukraine. Meron pa tayo, dapat tayong ma-recover down payment. The down payment na natin, ibigay natin down payment doon sa mga nasabi helicopter, 1.9 billion pesos. Is there any other, is there a way na malipo pa natin yun, mapabawi? Ano po status ng down payment na yun? Mapabawi pa ba yun? Or sa kanila na lang yung pera yun? And then, how will our proposed bills prevent future incidents like this? Yung 1.9 billion po, ano po status nun? Yung naibigay na po dun sa Russia para sa mga helicopters na kapila. Sayang po yun, malaking pera din po yung 1.9 billion. Marami po pwedeng mapaglaran yung punto yun sana kung mapapawi. 1.9 billion pesos po. Pesos.
Your Honor, we are currently exploring all our options on how we can recoup the 1.9 billion pesos advance payment po ito. 15% po ito ng total contract involving the 16 MiA-17 helicopters po. Sa ngayon po, ni-refer na din po namin yung matter sa OSG for further study. Kasi po, andyan po yung posibilidad na
magkakasuhan po kung sakasakali po i-terminate natin. Kasi po sinimulan na po natin yung proseso kung paano po natin i-terminate yung buong kontrata.
Okay. So, ano po ang binibigyan na reason ng RSI sa Russia kung bakit po nagmamati na sila at nilang kasaibigan na lang yung 1.9 billion pesos samantara hindi naman sila kapag-deliver?
Sir Chair Roger, ang isa po sa mga rason na ibinibigay po nila is kasi po may mga nagawa na po sila, ongoing production na po. Actually, Roger, it was only in September that we were able to convey the suspension of works. Yung September lang po natin sila napatigil sa pagbuo ng mga helicopter, Mr. Chair.
Okay. So, ano po mga measures na ginagawa natin in place kung meron man na parang hindi na umaulit o meron pas incidente na kung saan nag-advance payment tayo and then, of course, all of a sudden, mag-withdraw tayo and hindi natin kukunin, hindi natin mabago yung pera. At also, measures, Mr. Chair, na ma-prevent na ito ganito po nasing sitwasyon.
Siguro you can provide that in the contract between the Philippine government and the other government concerned. Wala ba sa contract yun? Just in case, katulad nga, biglang nag-cancel ng purchase ng Philippine government. Wala tayong safety net, wala tayong hapon.
Mr. Chair,
sabihin lang talaga ng Russia na hindi, ginagawa na natin. Kahit hindi ginagawa, hindi mo natin. Hindi mo natin wala lang. Talagang ginagawa na nila. Di ba? We have to...
Kahit na ginawa na nila, Mr. Chair, pwede mo na i-penetrate sa iba. O pwede mo gamitin sa kanila.
We have no knowledge kung talagang nagsisinungaling sila o nagsasabi sila ng totoo kung talagang ginagawa na nila yung helicopter. Salugi talaga yung Pilipinas. So, we have to have safety nets under the contract between the Philippine government and the Russian government. Meron bang provision dun sa contract niyan? Ano ba nakasaad sa contract? Because I'm not privy to
it. Yes, Mr. Chair. Ano naman po? In fact, Mr. Chair, it was the Philippine government who terminated the contract, Mr. Chair. Now, Mr. Chair, when we terminated, we invoked the termination for convenience na hindi na po siya feasible. Hindi na po feasible implementa yung kontrata sa ngayon, sir. Mr. Chair. Now, there's also this principle of quantum and weight. Yung sinasabi po nila na kung ano na po yung nagawa, maaari po natin makuha na. So, yun nga po, as mentioned in...
Meron bang representative sa inyo na pumunta sa Russia at pagtingnan kung talagang may ginagawa? At kung meron totoo naman, meron silang ginagawa na maumpisa na, pwede ba natin kunin?
Sa ngayon po, Mr. Chair, wala pa pong...
Mr. Chair, siguro yung sinasabi niya, ano yung nabayaran niya sa
insurance? Yes.
Yung mga edisin na po.
Actually, Your Honor, meron na po silang mga pinadalang litrato na nagawa na po nila. In fact, prior to the assumption of Secretary Teodoro, Sir Chair, then OIC Galvez approved a trip to Russia to inspect kung ano nga po ba talaga yung nagawa na.
So what happened to the inspection? Sabi nyo may pumunta si Secretary Galvez sa China, sa Russia, kung ano na ito nagawa. So ano po yung mga nagawa na base doon sa ginawa ng inspection?
Your Honor, hindi pa po na tutuloy yung trip to Russia. Ano lang po yun? Inaprobahan pa lang po ni Secretary, then Secretary Galvez during that time.
So wala mo kayong balak na pumunta doon para tingnan kung ano talaga yung nagawa na. Para kung sakali man nagawa na, hindi pwede natin kunin yung mga helicopter para hindi natin magpahirapan pa kapalit nung sa advance payment. Ma-quits na lang.
Well noted, Your Honor, that we'll consult with the Honorable Secretary.
Magkano binayad natin sa 1.9 billion? Magkano isang helicopter na supposedly binayad nila? Do you have any ballpark figure that relates to
us? Around 800, more or less.
800 million.
Ano isang helicopter?
Pesos.
pesos.
Isang helicopter?
Yes. Kasi po, Mr. Chair, the whole contract is around 12 billion.
Million, at 1.9 billion mo binayad natin. Pwede ay dalawang helicopter na.
Ayos. At ito lang, bakit napakamahal po 800 million? Anong kasi helicopter po ito?
Heavy.
60 seater.
Okay.
60 seater, Antonov, or high,
60
seater. Ano to, hassle helicopter?
Transport. It's geared towards HADR, po, yung humanitarian assistance and disaster relief, supposedly.
Okay, so tama si Senator Chingoy, kung 1.9 ang nagkas natin, 800 ang bawat isa, na helicopter na benta ng Russia. So, pwede naman po ng dalawa. Lumilad na tayo ng dalawang helicopter na doon. Ito na gawa na. Para medyo magawa.
Is that feasible? Is that possible?
Mr. Chair, the department is currently exerting all the efforts, Mr. Chair.
Okay, sabi niyo po, ito na sa court arbitration. Ano party po ito?
Wala pa po siya. Should we decide to formally terminate the contract. Ang pag-usapan po dito is we conveyed the pinag-aaralan pa lang po in the event na dumating po tayo.
Pag-aaral, so kailan po natin malalaman natapos yung pag-aaral?
Kasi po, Your Honor, we are exerting all efforts to reach an amicable settlement. Kasi po, kung sakasakali kung dumating po tayo sa arbitration, gastos din po. Nagdaging gastos din po.
Pero ano po pinaka-status? Ano po sinasabi nila? Are they cooperative? Are they okay ba sa kanila na later on, ibukod na nila yung television ilang mga helicopters na nagawa nila para mabawas ko sa conflict natin. Ano ang mamatigas sa sabihin na hindi na pwede kayo kumatras for information nila. At kung gano'n, looking po tayo ng 1.9. Kasi sabi mo na sa 40 na, wala mo pala sa 40. So kailan ho, kailan kayo magpagbigay sa amin ng definite time na para malaman natin yung tunay na estado ng 1.9 billion in terms of yung pera na yan ay mapabalik na sa atin.
Mr. Chair, Your Honor, sa ngayon po, tuloy-tuloy po yung consultations between the Russian counterpart and the DND.
Okay, so far po, ano po may nabubuhan na ho ba yung consultation na yun?
Mr. Chair, Your Honor, so as not to preempt the conduct of ongoing consultations, Mr. Chair, we allow to be the Honorable Senator's executive session. Kumaaki po sa executive
session. Okay, Mr. Chair, hindi lang yan masabi kung ginamit na sa'yo, pwede. Pero, Mr. Eric, may pag-aasa pa ba? Kasi matagal na ito eh. May pag-aasa pa ba kung ba yung pera? Or mukhang malabo na kailangan magporte pa. Kasi kung mabuti naman ang siyam-siyam at wala pa ito nangyari, it's better na sabi nga niya sa Jim Boy, sakay talaga ko doon. Matila na kayo dito ng helicopter yun, nagawa na. Which? Is that something na pwede naka-include sa contract? O kung wala mo sa contract, eh pwede ba yung parang pag-uusap na lang between two countries para mabawi man lang yung pera yung nawala sa atin? Or 1.9 billion na mukhang mawawala na? Kung hindi tayo kagawa ng anumang hapak.
Your Honor, Your Chair, we can probably give you a clearer answer in the executive session.
Okay, I respect that.
Maybe in the next hearing.
Yes, I
Senator Francis.
Thank you.
Thank you, Senator Rafi.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I apologize for being late, but then we now attend that day meeting with Lieutenant Colonel Tammy Duckworth. Tammy Duckworth is now the incumbent senator from Illinois. She is a member of the Armed Services Committee of the U.S. Senate, perhaps the wood on the 6th floor. A lot of issues were discussed concerning the relationship with the United States, among others, but Mr. Chairman, I would like to ask a specific question which has been lingering on my mind for the last several weeks. And perhaps the DND officers here can answer me. Since 2008, as we speak now, meron tayong dalawang kadete na nasa U.S. Naval Academy sa Annapolis, Pilipino. Meron akong dating tao na nandun ngayon sa Fort Rucker, Alabama, na training. Since 2008, nag-stop na tayo tumanggap ng counterpart cadets from the United States going to the Philippine Military Academy. You can confirm this later. Nagtataka ako, tuwing meron tayong, Mr. Chairman, tuwing meron tayong commission on appointments hearing, yung binabasa kong mga kapal na folder, ang dami tayong mga military officers, O6, yung majors, nung dumaan sila, eh graduate ng Beijing Military Academy. Nag-aaral sa China, PLA Military Academy. Can you confirm this? We have stopped accepting cadets from the United States since 2008. Now we're sending our cadets, PLA graduates or cadets, to the Beijing Military Academy. Ano pong dahil na dito? Tinigil natin yung ating pagtanggap ng kadete galing Amerika. Nagpapadala tayo ng kadete sa U.S. Air Force Academy, U.S. Naval Academy, sa Annapolis, U.S. West Point. Subalit, hindi tayo tumatanggap ng kadete galing sa Amerika. Nagpapadala naman tayo ng kadete sa Beijing Military Academy sa China. Anong rasyonal nito? Hindi ko lang tinatanong pag may commission on appointments here. Pero nakikita ko doon sa mga biodata, eh graduate ng Beijing. Paano nangyari ito? Can somebody explain this? Doon tayo sa may treaty at ally natin, hindi tayo tumatanggap. Yung nagaharas sa atin sa West University, pinapadala naman natin yung mga kadete natin galing Henry. Can somebody explain the rationale behind this? Kanina hindi ko na ni-raise kay, alam mo, si Senator Tommy Duckworth, kaya ano yan, putol yung dalawang paa niya na RPG yan sa Iraq. Helicopter pilot yan ng Iraq War. Senator from Illinois, kaalis lang ng building na to. So, can somebody explain this na paano nag-stop tayo ng 2008 tapos nagpapadala naman tayo sa Beijing Military Academy? DND?
Your Honor.
Is that correct? Background information that I got?
I think so, Your Honor.
What do you mean you think so? Tama.
Right,
wala na tayong tinatanggap na kasi kung araw, may mga general serving na U.S. Army, graduate ng PLA.
Yes, sir.
Meron mga admirals, commodores, graduate ng Philippine Military Academy. Nag-aaral dito. Tayo naman, di ba, ang dami na ng napag-graduate natin sa Annapolis, sa West Point, etc., etc. Pero ngayon, pinapag-graduate natin sa Beijing Military Academy. Tama yan?
Your Chair, before I retired from the service, I was superintendent of DNA. And I asked that question also.
Okay.
Why U.S. is stopped sending cadets?
When did you retire, sir?
2013, sir.
2013. Wala pa si Rowan. Wala pa, hindi pa siya ang natap sa DNA. Di ba?
89, sir.
Okay. Go ahead.
Yes, sir. And they said the U.S. is stopped sending cadets to us, but other countries like Singapore, they continue to send cadets to PLA. Also Malaysia, they sent cadets to PLA. But I think recently, they're no longer sending cadets.
There must be a reason. So, because of that, I need another reason why we're now sending cadets to the Beijing Military Academy. Interoperable ba yung ano natin, yung doctrine natin doon sa trade-off na pasok sa Chinese military doctrine? So, pare, naguguluhan ako doon. Kailan tayo nagsimulang magpadala sa Beijing Military Academy ng Kates? Baka Chinese na yung salita doon, pagbalik dito.
We will check and we will ask.
But is that true? Is that correct? Hindi nyo ang kadete ba? As
we speak up. I heard about it.
So, meron tayong magiging mga general
nag-graduate ng Beijing. Diba? Meron. Tapos, at the same time, meron din tayong mga pinagdadala sa tuloy-tuloy, sa Annapolis, tuloy-tuloy. Tumigil naman tayo. Can you provide this community? There must be a reason why they stop sending cadets coming from the United States. Can you provide this media requirement to Mr. Chairman? Can you provide this committee a concrete black and white reason why they stop? There must be a reason. Hindi naman dahil walang visa yun. There must be a reason. And then, can you provide this committee a reason why we started sending cadets to the Beijing military? I don't know if that's the correct name for the military institution.
You will do that.
Are we requiring them or encouraging our cadets to study at the Beijing Military Academy? I think it's quite alarming, no? And this is the first time I heard the news coming from Senator Tuyutino. Are we encouraging them to study in the Military Academy of Beijing?
Your Honor, I cannot answer that. I have to find out the reason why they are sending the cadets to China.
Who is in charge? Who is in charge of this? Jay Nance is in charge. So, may allowance yun? May allowance din yun sa Chinese government.
I'm sure, yes.
May allowance yun. May billeting, lodging, accommodation yun. May patch yun. Pag-graduate ka ng ano. And you must learn likewise to sing the national anthem. People's public in China. Alarming. Indeed. Mr. Chairman, sa Cebuano, salita ito, dalipong. Nahino. So, I think this has to be explained. This has to be explained. A lot of our young, we are promoting ROTC or about to revive ROTC. Yung pala, meron sa pinapadala naman doon sa magulo to, Mr. Chairman. They're not there to not just to learn Chinese culinary and even use chopsticks. Di ba? Iba yung doctrine na siguro to. I just raised that, Mr. Chairman, for the information of this committee.
Thank you for providing this vital information, and I am as surprised as you are, because I don't think, or I don't know if the Defense Department or the FBI are suggesting our cadets to start.
Yes, because I read an article, that's part of what we call Chinese promoting influence globally, Nigerian entertainment, American, Chinese influence, Nigerian education, sa ngayon military, nandiyan pa yung BRI, yung Belt Road Initiative, ayun na, nakikita natin very clearly na talagang kumakalat na yung influence ng China. So this, ito na masakit po, ito mumuti nga, sinabi ito ni Senator Tolentino, na pati yung military natin, ma-interpret na nila, kumakita ng pagbibigyan ng free education sa mga generals natin. And then, what happens after mag-graduate yung mga generals dyan, they bring down the loob sa China, doon sila natuto about Chinese influence and Chinese cultures. E baka naman, pag nahuli, makalimutan naman kanta ng Bayang Magilio at alam na yung national anthem ng China. This is very alarming. So, my question to you, Sec. Espino, alam niyo po pala, bakit hindi niyo po pinatitigil? This has to stop.
Your Honor, your chair,
sorry po, sir, kasi sampal po sa atin, binubuli po tayo ng China, and yet yung ating mga military natin wala magawa. Tapos ngayon, yung mga military natin na hindi kayang haharapin ng China para sabihin, stop, pinakalala natin sa China para makalang, so parang sampal po sa atin ito. Yung sensor.
I agree, Your Honor. I was given a note a while ago. Only CGSE and MMSA counterparts were available by officers of the armed forces. I have to check if there are cadets sent to China.
So,
wala pa pong
GSC
counterparts
and Lieutenant Colonel to.
Lieutenant Colonel.
Punta sa China. Yes. So, totoo, di ba? Yes. There are cadets or one class to, ano to?
Yes, sir. Or senior officers.
Hindi naman siguro 1 week lang to. Visiting the Great Wall, visiting
one year course.
Alam niyo po, Mr. Chair, Lisa Pagema, I want to mention who the Chief of Staff then was.
nung battalion commander ko ako sa reserve, may parada sa Aguinaldo. Ako yung maglilid sa parade. Sabi, babuhin nyo yung steps nyo. Ang pinagawa sa akin nun, yung two steps. Sabi ko, saan natin nakuha ito?
Sa China.
Yung matataas sir yung hanggang. Ginaya natin yun eh, di ba?
Yeah, I did that, sir.
Nag-Gustavs tayo. Ilang years tayo nag-Gustavs? Ang hirap mo. Sumakit yung meron ko.
That was during the time of the race.
What's on? Hindi natin ano. So again, yung mga influence na ganito, hindi natin maalis eh. Nagmamarcha naman tayo. God bless you, sir. Nagmamarcha naman tayo na maayos. Pero ginaya natin yung marcha ng China. Yung dahan-dahan na matatakas na ganun.
Di ba rin mapanda? Paano mo ako yung mga mapanda?
Nahirapan lahat. So, sir, I just raised this point. Para yung... Yes. But we need the report for the committee. The reasons for the two. Bakit nag-stop yung US cadets sa PMA? Bakit tayo nagpapadala? Exchange ba ito? Do we have MNSA JSC Chinese counterparts, especially?
That was the note given to me, sir.
Merong market sa atin.
Yes, sir.
So may access din sila sa grounds and records natin that has to be re-evaluated. So nakatira din sila sa Aguinaldo?
As of now, sir, wala po kung ano sa Chinese
GSC.
GSC.
May I suggest, Mr. Chair, siguro itignan muna natin any dealings dito sa China in terms of military exchange, especially the fact na meron nangyari si Galo between China and Philippines at yung pamubuli ng Chinese sa military, sa ating mga militar dito. So huwag muna kasi kung ipapatuloy natin yan, yung mga military natin, Lieutenant Colonel, papadala sa Beijing Military Academy, parang insulto po yun. Can we put a stop to it? Put a break right away? Marami pa naman ibang academy na pwede yung padahan. Bakit sa Beijing pa na kung saan we perceive as enemy just because they've been bullying us for a long, long time.
Yes, sir. I was going to inform PSMJ about
Third question, with the permission of the chair. It's not just the armed forces of the Philippines, but the Philippine National Police as well. They're sending cadets to Beijing. Can you confirm that?
The representative from the Philippine National Police here? Yeah? I don't think.
You can verify from your counterparts.
Can you please provide us with a comprehensive report about what Senator Tolentino provided us with this vital information? Because I, as chairman, find it very, very alarming that we are sending or we are encouraging or whatever cadets or even our high officers to Beijing. Please provide us with a comprehensive report.
Yes, sir.
Yes, you say,
Mr. Chairman, kasi po, last na lang po ba, makalimutan. Directed sa DND, ano, meron po ba tayo mga computer hardware na made in China sa military? Then, meron po kasi ako narinig at one time, bumili na po yung ating militar ng mga computer parts, mga laptop computers na mura from China. Is that true?
No idea or no report
that we have
been.
Can you start checking
for?
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Senator Rafi.
Yusuf Papago? Mr. Chair, Your Honor, thank you for this support. Dadagdag ko lang po, hindi lang po military pinapadala sa China. May mga nag-aaral po doon, mga postgrad, invite from China po. Mga scholarship, civilians.
Inihibit lang ng Chinese?
Opo. So they take up postgraduate studies in China.
Where in China? Sa military, right?
Hindi po, iba ibang universities.
Anong inaaway nila? ang kinukuha ng course.
Mga postgraduate studies
Like
on,
like what?
Marami pong nga rin, depende po sa available na in-offer nila ang kurso, then tinatanggap ng mga applicants natin ito kung mapasa sa proseso nila.
These are private individuals now?
Yes, pangalan natin, citizens natin in district here.
That's
one way of promoting Chinese influence. Like I said earlier, Mr. Chair, because even in Western countries, they're doing that. The fact that bandang huli, may infiltrate na tayo ng PLA quietly without us knowing it. Dahil marami na pala tayo mga kababayan na pinag-aral doon, sinusuporta pa ng Chinese money para mag-aral doon, and then when they come back, we don't know, baka iba na tayo na umusuportak na mayroon. And then, pero again, I'm really concerned doon sa mga computer parts natin, computer hardware, kasi alam nyo naman kung si Boy, taga-DICT, may taga-DICT ba rito, na meron ng way na yung pinagagalingan ng computer, lalagyan po ng virus siya, and it will be called, if you will, yung sleeper. Matutulog lang po yung virus na yun. Pag dumating sa intended target nila, meron siya matutulog din doon, then yung virus na yun, it will do what is intended. It was intended to make. Ito, yun po delikado. Kaya po, kayo sa military, wag na wag po kayong bumili ng mga computers na galing po sa China. Please lang, wag po talaga.
Can you check on this, you said this, Pino? Please give us a report.
Yung mga personal po ninyo, wag yung po bumili ng mga cellphone from China. Hindi po. Bumili na kayo, anak nila, wala po kayo endorso. Na
brand.
Wag lang po China. Oh. Okay. Pero po yung... Ano ba ito? Oh, meron pala itong... Ano to? Ano to? Oh, Miss Latel signed deal to build facilities in military camps. Oh, China to. AFP, Miss Latel signed deal to build facilities in military camps. For me, Miss Latel Consortium includes Chinese government. Oh, ba't yung pinayagan to? Oh, magbibuild ng...
When was signed?
Yeah.
Senator Abi, when was the signed?
Kailan ba itong ano to? September 2019, itong article na ito.
2019?
I'm just quoting Rappler, ano? Ito sa article sa Rappler. 2019, September 11, 2019. AFP missed that assigned bill to build facilities in military camps. So, ibig sabihin, yung Chinese ay nakipagpirmahan sa AFP natin na para mag-build ng mga facilities, telecom facilities inside Camp Aguinaldo as mga kampo ng military natin.
This was during the previous administration, if it was
yes, of course.
2019?
Yes. Ano po status? Ah, ito ata yung ano, yung dito. Dito. Yes. Ano po yung status? No? Na-build na po yung tore ng dito na na-build po China?
Yes, sir. We will just submit the report regarding
that. Naka po yung pakipaklas. Instead, maglagay lang tayo. Okay lang sa akin po. Yung globe, smart, you know, yung sa atin. Pero kung maglagay po tayo, maglagay tayo ng telecommunication ng mga bagay-bagay sa military from China, iba usapan po yun. Diba? So, baka po yung mga telecom facilities, pagbawal na po muna, ilagas natin military camps. Just because meron po nangyari si Galo sa ating pasangay between Chinese, China and the Philippines. Diba? So, ano po nangyari doon? Wala po nangyari status?
We do not have any status on that, sir. But we will furnish a copy.
In fact, if I remember, Mr. Chair, during the last hearing with the ICT, I did mention about this, and the ICT confirmed na may risk nga raw talaga na para allowing. Although may mga ibang telecommunication company tulad ng Smart and Globe na inallow din ng mga kampo ng militar natin, pero na, mayroon yung risk na i-allow natin yung China na maglagay po ng putak ng telecommunication facilities, equipment sa kampo natin militar. Na nandun yung risk na madali silang pwede mag-eavesdrop sa atin. Of all places, bakit sila pa ng military? Lima?
At any rate, can you just submit to us the status report of what Senator Rabi has mentioned? Pwede in the week?
Yes.
So we can share it with some members of this committee. Anyway, this happened during the previous administration, I think. You all already have all the documents ready. Senator Rabi, any other questions?
Yes, Mr. Chairman. I hate to be mabulit, pero please lang, pakibaklas na po. Yung mga computers na galing China sa na, ngayon ay nasa military facilities, military properties, pakialis, remove immediately, and then ito po ang pasilidad na China po ang nag-stop, telecommunication facility, kung pwede ho, i-cancel na po yung contract at policy na po. So this is one way to show this Chinese government, Chinese, na binubuhol nyo kami, ito yung kapalit na hindi kami papayag na hanggang pa naman sa loob ng lupa namin, nakapasok kayo. Kato yun din lang kayo sa laot, pero huwag din sa loob ng Pilipinas. Yun ang po sana message, strong message that we can send to them at least. Yun ang po. Maraming salamat po, Mr. Chair. Thank you po.
Thank you, Senator Rafi. I know where Senator Rafi is coming from. Yung talagang pati naman ako. And I think all other senators here, Chef Kremot. Madalas na tayo kulit nito mga Chinese because of their incursions. At hindi lang man sa kung guys sila nagpunta dito sa ating territory, but yung mas maraming guys, but we filed a lot of diplomatic protests at the Nobel, thousands of diplomatic protests at the Nobel. That's why I know where Senator Rabi is coming from. At any rate, before we adjourn, Senator Joel Villanueva is requesting that the statement be inserted into the records of the committee. Please take note from SEC. Thank you, Senator Rafi. And again, the committee will create a technical working group to discuss the problems that we were discussing earlier. And the committee secretariat will coordinate with your respective offices to schedule the PWG meetings. And we expect your full cooperation to allow the preparation of the committee report as soon as possible. And again, I would like to thank all the resource persons who attended this hearing, and I hope we can have a more bills that will be passed with the airport cooperation. Thank you very much. If you have any anyway, thank you very much again for your presence. So here it is, here by adjourned.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.